Hey everybody, it's FortyWire. Welcome back to Mighty Number 9. With Bad out of the way, that's the last Mighty Number, and now we have two more stages to go. Prison and Robot Factory. Which would be the second to last and third to last stages in the game, depending on what order you take them in. I'm going to take care of the prison first because that's just what I do. Then? But each of them has their own challenges.
System ready? Go!
So with Call here...
Alright. This must be the main prison building. Dr. Blackwell's cell will be deeper inside.
There's a few differences between Call and Mech's attacking. Security wing, Doctor. Please wait here. But the most notable thing is you can't absorb with Call. She does have like a sort of bow ray gun or whatever you want to call it. And the key here is to find security cards so you can use them. Also, nice touch. I didn't mention this in Cryo Stage, but you see the camera. You get to see yourself moving in it on the screen over there, which is kind of cool. Also, really annoying, Call announces all her attacks, all her movements, all her actions. Also, that's a bomb. That's not... Yeah, don't want to get touched by that thing. Oh, ledge. Yep, I forgot about that ledge. Also, she can crawl through stuff, which is nice. Like I said, this is stealth. She's not gonna overpower enemies. And even these security robots, you notice I'm avoiding. You can't defeat them, you can only stun them. So, that's a major damper on her firepower. Not to mention the whole absorption thing. And you get these little patch service bots.
Perfect timing. Call. Plug in to recharge your shield energy. Use that as fuel to power your energy barrier. And press the shield button to activate it.
Charging complete. Which means that Call can negate any bullets coming her way.
Why was I equipped with an energy shield?
You never know. You know.
I don't know, actually. By the way, the stage isn't too bad because it understands that you can't use raw power like you're used to. So you sort of have to improvise and sort of strategize your approach as opposed to, you know, just, you know, using back end, absorbing everything that moves. And also, yes, you can glide through the air, which is also nice. This enemy you can destroy, however. It doesn't move, which is nice. All you have to do is just get to the eye. And watch as it blows itself up. And that's the only security card for this area, so let's get out of here. I don't need a charge. I'm doing well as it is. And now we get to an obligatory enemy rush.
Ah, yes, this door is locked electronically. One sec while I hack it open.
Alright, Sonda.
Great Caesar's ghost!
Great Caesar's ghost? Oh, you wuss.
Please focus on hacking the terminal. I will try to neutralize any threats.
Or you'll suffer the Call death stare. Oh, it's more of these clingy bots that are also bombs and will blow themselves up. Basically, all you have to do is just knock them away with the thing and they'll eventually detonate themselves. Yes, that absorption thing can get mad annoying at times. You can detonate now. You can detonate now, thank you. Ah, I almost got it in one try. Shit. Yeah, showing off a little bit. What of it? Oh. What'd I just say about not using back? I ducked it, but whatever. That's neither here nor there. Also, you can't recover your health. So that might be a major mistake.
Interesting.
What is it, Call?
I often detect an aversion to combat in Beck's vocal patterns, while I have no such reluctance. Question. Why would Professor White include that hesitation in his design? It's illogical.
We'll leave the logic points to, Mr. Spock, okay?
Yo, Dr.
Just focus on getting shit done.
You got some call, huh? Make her I reached you. I scouted up ahead and spotted a nasty guard dog. I'm talking one sick puppy.
That's the boss.
Pro tip, blast his big eye first. It's his weak point. Then go for massive damage.
Yep. So, Ivy just basically told you how to take care of the boss.
All of Professor White's designs have such contradictions.
That actually is supposed to be part of the story, I believe. The whole hesitation thing, you'll see why. But, for right now...
Error.
Ooh, yay! Health pickup. Too bad I don't have the E-tanks. Sir, stay away from me. Oh yes, this thing drains really quick, just FYI. Oh, and don't forget the security guard here. I don't like the fact that Call announces all his attacks. It's just annoying as hell to me.
Barrier!
Oh god, this area, I hate it. Of course, they have to have a /jetpack evasion thing. That's sort of the way to win. It just gets tricky around that part because you wouldn't think to just do a double dash, but you kind of have to there, and not do it immediately. You have to wait a little bit, but still one of the tougher parts. Very annoying part too. That actually took me a long time to get used to. Like I said, I play this game a bunch, so I know how to get through these areas now, but it doesn't change the fact that it's a pain in the ass, and there's no shame to die there. And here's our guard dog, K9, but I'm shh.
Call, do you remember Abby's advice?
Affirmative, Doctor. Knock the eye out first.
Once you knock the eye out, K9 just basically blindly jumps around and shoots his gun in a random pattern, which you can only avoid by doing this. Or, you know, use the barrier to your advantage. But the barrier's temporary, so... It's good to know how to do that, too. And it's a bomb to start, yay! Bomb obviously does tons of damage. Sometimes the security bot ends up showing there instead. It would just basically restore his vision, but overall... It's, sort of random what comes out. It's just a little tedious fight, is all. I'm not a fan of it, but that's to be expected when you're using a robot that's based on stealth, not... And now we're gonna get the vision camera back. And it went away. With the camera, K9 will usually do more concentrated, bullet attacks. Where he might just concentrate and do burst fire, or he'll do like a long sustained bullet fire that goes straight, which the only way to really avoid is with the barrier. But the big thing about taking that camera out quickly is if you don't, he might actually do that camera, he might actually try to eat you, which will hurt you a lot. And also, because it would protect his eye, it would make him basically invulnerable. So that's kind of the reason you want to get the camera out of the way very quickly. Call it a punishment for not doing your job fast enough. Yeah. Ooh, got it. Nice. These can go with that sustained stream of bullets, too. Where it's just going to be one long stream going straight. basically now 5 shots to the eye or another bomb will destroy him. All depends what shows up. And it looks like we're going to get the security bot, which means we're going to do that. And there you go. Pretty simple boss, nothing major. Just sort of just there, I guess you could say. The whole stage is basically just there, in my opinion, because it's fairly minimalistic. And that's a really low score to get an A in. Just thought I'd point that out. But we're done here, thank God. So we get to talk to Blackwell. What does he want to tell us? Oh, hey, Patch. I guess we'll find out later. Anyway, that's it for this part. As you see, all the Patch bots are now running the asylum. Ugh. But we got more important things to worry about, such as a robot factory that needs to be shut down. So we'll take care of that in the next part. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.